Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz brain builder about lymphocytes. The cells of the lymphatic system are termed lymphocytes. These cells are responsible for specific, also referred to as acquired, immunity. This type of immunity is not inherited at birth. Rather, it is acquired over time following exposure to pathogens. The two types of specific immunity are artificial or natural. Artificial immunity is acquired through vaccinations, while natural immunity is acquired by everyday encounters and exposures to disease-causing agents and pathogens. Lymphocytes are the primary cells of the immune system and are found within the lymphatic and cardiovascular systems, as well as within the interstitial spaces of the body. When a lymphocyte encounters a pathogen, it will initiate an immune response. There are three classes of lymphocytes: T cells, B cells, and NK cells. Each cell type has distinctive biochemical and functional characteristics. Let's talk a little bit more about each of these types of lymphocytes. T cells comprise the largest percentage of lymphocytes. These cells originate in bone marrow and then migrate to the thymus to become immunocompetent or activated. When properly stimulated, T cells differentiate into several different cell types that will attack antigens and increase the body's immune response. B cells are the second most common form of lymphocytes. These originate and become immunocompetent within the red bone marrow. Immunocompetent B cells divide and differentiate into either plasma cells, known as plasmacytes, which secrete antibodies, or they become memory B cells. Memory B cells become activated only if the antigen appears again in the body at a later date. NK cells, also termed natural killer cells, attack foreign cells, normal cells infected with a virus, and cancer cells that appear within normal tissues. Lymphocytosis is having a higher than normal lymphocyte count. There are few, if any, symptoms with lymphocytosis, and it usually occurs after an illness and is most of the time considered harmless and temporary. Occasionally, lymphocytosis can be serious and an indication of blood cancer or a chronic infection. Lymphocytopenia is the opposite of lymphocytosis. With lymphocytopenia, the body doesn't have enough lymphocytes that help defend the body from viruses, cancer, and other intruders. Lymphocytopenia is linked to many different diseases and conditions. Next, we will look at the symptoms, causes, and treatments for lymphocytopenia, and finally, give a patient example. The symptoms for lymphocytopenia may be related to an underlying cause or condition of the patient, causing them to have a low lymphocyte count. These symptoms can include a fever, cough, runny nose, enlarged lymph nodes, small lymph nodes, joint pain, skin rashes, night sweats, and weight loss. While many conditions and illnesses may cause lymphocytopenia, there are three reasons that may cause the lymphocyte numbers of a patient to drop. The first reason is the body doesn't make enough lymphocytes, like when the bone marrow is affected by diseases such as aplastic anemia or leukemia. The second reason is the body makes enough lymphocytes in other blood cells, but they're being destroyed faster than the bone marrow can replace them. This can be seen in autoimmune diseases. And the third reason may be the spleen or lymph nodes have trapped the lymphocytes where they are normally stored, and your body is not able to use them to fight a disease or infection. Treatment for lymphocytopenia requires treating the underlying cause. This usually resolves the lymphocytopenia. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 45. Sex, female. Chief complaints, a fever and cough with a general unwell feeling. You invite the patient into your office for an examination. Your patient has not been feeling very well and thinks she has picked up the flu. Your patient explains how she is worried though, because she had COVID just over a month ago and then a few weeks later picked up strep throat. And now it seems she is sick again. She has not been able to fully recover from one sickness without immediately going into the next. Something more serious may be going on with your patient, more than just a cold or a flu. You send for some blood tests to be run. The blood test results show a very low number of lymphocytes, indicating lymphocytopenia. You begin running other tests to explore the root issue, which could be a multitude of diseases or conditions. Looking at the test results, you see no concern for an issue with the lymphocytes being produced in the bone marrow or an indication of an autoimmune disease. You hypothesize that the lymphocytes are being trapped in the spleen and lymph nodes of your patient, which is why your patient is not able to fight off the different diseases. You continue further testing and start your patient on immunotherapy to help her feel better. This is a classic example of lymphocytopenia. Did you like this video? Consider checking out BodyViz 3D Anatomy Learning Platform for a complete article and activities supporting this video. To learn more about BodyViz and what other resources we have available for instructors and students, go to bodyviz.com.